you wouldn't go out and just go plant corn without making sure your planter was behaving properly. So we're going to do the same thing with the grain drill.
To calibrate a grain drill, you need to know a few basic pieces of information. You'll need to know the number of seeds that are in a given pound of the grain that you'll be planting. And you'll need to decide on what planting population and seeding rate you'll be shooting for. Then you'll need to simulate the seeding of a given area to know whether your drill is seeding at the rate you want. Based on what you learn, you adjust your drill and try it again.
Almost all drills have what I would call factory specs for seeding rates, but they're like more approximations or guesstimations is a good place to start. If you look over there, there's the chart on the lid, and most drills have the charts on the lids if they haven't already gotten worn out. And that has multiple crops and all the different rates that you could imagine, but those are for guesstimated seed sizes. And every seed lot is going to be different, just like in corn and soybeans. One batch of seed may be slightly different sized than the other, and that can really affect how this thing drills, because it basically is metering out a volume of seed, doesn't have a seed counter that individually counts like plate planter. So it's just grabbing wads of seed and dumping it out. And so since we're doing volume, we need to make sure that the volume that we're putting on has the number of seeds in it we need. We counted the seed out because this is my own rye that I grew last year. And so we don't have any information from a seed company as far as seeds per pound to let us do our calculation and our calibration properly. So we counted out by hand 1,000 seeds, which actually worked out to be exactly an ounce, which is very lucky. It's not always how that works out, but it's slow and it's tedious, but it's really important so that we get our calibration right for our planting population.
So the first step, as Wade says, is to figure out the number of seeds in a pound. And to do that, you'll want to count out 1,000 seeds. Less than that probably isn't enough, and more is probably not necessary. You'll weigh that, as Wade did, and you'll use that weight to figure out how many seeds are in a pound.
We counted them all out by hand, and now that we know how many seeds we have per ounce, we then know how many seeds we have per pound, and I can then calibrate my drill for the flow rate that comes out to make sure that we have the right amount coming out.
Once you get your seeds per pound, you can pick a population. What should you shoot for? Well, it depends on the crop, variety, and timing. Vic shoots for about 1.3 million with oats. With several PFI farmers, David tested populations that ranged from 1 million to about 1.6 million plants per acre. But regardless of what you decide on, the most important thing is to keep good records and be able to adjust that rate in the future. To get at that desired plant stand, you need to also figure in stand loss and germination rate, and you can do that using the following formula. To get the seeding rate in pounds per acre, you need to take your target population and divide by the stand loss, and then divide that number by the number of seeds that germinate. So let's use Wade as an example. He got his winter rye in early, so he went for a lower target population because he knew it would have time to establish well and produce lots of tillers. This rate would probably be a little bit too low for oats, especially if you were getting them in late. And he wanted somewhere around 800 to 900,000 plants per acre at harvest, and we'll figure his stand loss at 15%. Generally, 10 to 20% is a good estimate for that number. And his germination rate at 95%. So let's do the math. Using this formula, we come up with a seeding rate of a little over 1 million seeds per acre. Once we've picked a target population and seeding rate, we can find out the rate our drill is actually seeding. Because we know how many pounds are in a given volume of seed, we just need to simulate seeding a known area and then weigh the seed from that simulation.
So the book tells us how to calibrate it on the more exact rate. And so what they recommend to do in this one, it says 3 units side by side, and put seed, enough seed in those units to be able to run them properly, and then collect the seed that comes out, weigh that, do it a couple times, and then you'll have your calibration. So we're gonna have our collection device, which is a handy dandy old seed bag with nothing in it. And we're gonna put it underneath, and if I get it set right, it'll catch all three without making a mess. So that's there to catch the seed. Then we go around here, and on all box drills are driven by something, usually a main drive wheel. This is a bigger machine, it's a 30-foot machine, and so this unit is driven by drive wheels on the ends. And so what we have to do, since it's not a three-point mounted unit, a three-point mounted unit's easy because you just pick it up with a tractor and you can spin the wheel freehand. This one we have to jack it up because that's a carrying wheel, so it helps hold the planter up. So we have to jack up the wheels to get them so they spin freely. And then we'll go ahead and rotate as the path of travel. And the book recommends to do at least 20 revolutions and then check how much seed and scale it. So we're gonna do 20. 1, 2, 3. All right, 20.
In order to find out the area that you're seeding, you need to know the circumference of the tire and the number of revolutions that tire makes in order to know the length. And based on those numbers, we can calculate the length that we seeded. To find the width, we need to know the row spacing. Wade's drill has 7.5 inch spacing. And we also need to know the number of tubes we disconnected to know the number of rows that we planted. In this case, Wade unhooked 3 tubes to catch seed from. So 3 7.5-inch rows is more or less 2 feet. From there, it's simple. We multiply length by width to get the area in square feet and convert that to acres to know the area in acres that we seeded.
Now we'll see what we've got in our bag here. Now, I had this originally set for the factory settings of a single bushel, an acre. My goal is to put on about 1 million seeds per acre. Now, since I'm using my own seed, I had to run it through a seed cleaner to make sure that I'm not reseeding a bunch of weeds or sticks or other things that would really screw up our calculations. All right, so that was 4.5, and now we got to do a calculation.
Wade's sample from the 3 tubes weighed 4.5 ounces, or about 0.28 pounds. And when we divide that by our area in acres, we get a rate of a little more than 39 pounds of seed per acre, which we know is a little over 600,000 seeds per acre.
All right, so now we've got our rate. We found out we're running at 630,000, which is a little short, so we're going to increase. We've just increased the seed meters, hopefully about a third to a third and a half, and we'll see how close we are. All right, so we'll start here and do our 20 again. Well, we certainly have more seed, which is good. Okay, and we now have 7.2 ounces instead of 4.5, so that's good.
After adjusting the seed meters, Wade's sample was about 0.45 pounds, which meant his seeding rate was a little over 63 pounds per acre, or just about right on his target seeding rate of 1 million seeds per acre. Now, all he has to do is adjust the rest of the drill accordingly, and he's ready to plant.
There. Tighten it up. Done. Real easy.